Hi, PB Kids. This week we're talking about the story of a woman who lived a long time ago, long before even Jesus was born. Her name was Hagar, and she was a slave to Abram and Sarai. Now, Abram and Sarai, better known as Abraham and Sarah, are important in the Bible too. Actually, really important. But today isn't about their story, it's Hagar's. That's the cool thing about life sometimes. Other people can have a really big and awesome story that everyone knows and cares and talks about. And your story is just as important. Even if it doesn't seem as big and special. And today is Hagar's turn to share her story, because her story is big and special to God. Hagar didn't have an easy life. In fact, she had a really hard life. She was a slave, which meant Abram and Sarai owned her. She didn't have a choice in much of anything she did. We know that this is not right. You can't own people, but it's what happened. Abram wanted a son, and Abram and Sarai thought they couldn't have children, so Hagar was the mother. And Sarai treated her badly, so badly, Hagar fled. She ran far away until she was all alone in the desert. I don't know exactly how Hagar felt, but I bet she felt pretty alone. The people who were supposed to love and care for her didn't do a good job, and now she was all by herself. What was she supposed to do next? And then something amazing happened. An angel of God appeared to her, and you know what that angel said? They told her to go back. What? Back to the people who treated her unkindly? Yes, God said to go back. Now, this isn't always the answer. We shouldn't always go back to people who have treated us badly. But the angel told Hagar that even if Abram and Sarai didn't really see her or notice her wants and needs, God noticed her. God saw her. God promised to make a big and huge, beautiful thing out of her life. God was promised that she would have a big family, starting with the baby boy in her tummy. And she did. But before she went back that day, she thought of a very special name for God. She called him El Roy. El Roy is Hebrew and means the God who sees. This was probably the most special name Hagar could have thought of, because she recognized she was seen by God during a time where she felt alone and unseen and forgotten about. God saw her, and it's a promise and reminder for us that God always sees us and cares for us. This is a reminder for you. God sees you. God sees you even when it feels like you're alone, even when things are hard and people don't care the way you wish they would. Even when you feel forgotten, God sees you. Wait a minute. It's February 14th. Happy Valentine's Day. Want to bake some cookies with me? Join us at 1 p.m. We'll be crafting too. Even if you don't have all the supplies, hop in and hang out with us. February 28th, we're having a crafting event as well. See you there. Email me and I can set aside a crafting bag for you to pick up at the church. Remember, you are special and loved just the way you are by God. Have a great week.